What is going on, you guys? My name is Craigo Crystal, or you can call me Craigo, and welcome back to Pokemon Omega Ruby Randomizer Nuzlocke. In the last episode, we made our way here to Lily Cove City, and this episode, we're going to get a few encounters and head to Mount Pyre to deal with Team Magma as they're trying to steal the Red Orb, which, spoilers, if you don't know where the Red Orb is right here. If you don't know where that came from, make sure you go back and check the playlist down below. It does have all the videos that of this series, and make sure to check the channel. There's always going to be other series for you to watch. Anyways, quick team recap here. We got Malware, the Porygon Zed with Recovery, Magnet Rise, Signal Beam, and Embargo. Tempest, the Thunderous T with Revenge, Bite, Shockwave, and Swagger. Plushie, the Mew with Steel Wing, Psychic, False Swipe, and Mega Punch. Jessica, the Lopunny with Mega Kick, nope, Quick Attack, Jump Kick, Dizzy Punch, and Agility. Pompeii, the Camera Up with Yawn, Overheat, Lava Plume, and Earth Power. And finally, we got Vibe, our Frog, with Mud Shot, Surf, Drain Punch, and Meteor Mash. So, I'm gonna actually quickly do a Pokeball check. Let's organize it really quick. By type. Boom. So we got all our Mega Stones together now, which is good. So how many Ultra Balls do we have? We have 9. I think we should go purchase some more.
Oh my god, hey Craigo!
I forgot about this.
Don't tell me you were shopping too. You're here for shopping too. Oh my god, so cool. Look at that mall. It's so big. Right in front of us is the famous Lily Cove department store after all. I mean, when I saw you, I figured maybe you'd come here to do some shopping same as me. Oh my god, it's so cool. I'm afraid I already bought tons of stuff, like Pokemon dolls and posters, and but that's not all I've been doing, of course. I've been catching tons of Pokemon, like, oh my god, there's so many. And I've been raising them, well, I think. You totally think I'm lying, but, like, I'm not. Like, you totally, that little totally said you think I'm lying. The bigger question is whether you're raising your Pokemon right, not me. So let's sell it. Oh!
Okay. I wasn't ready for that. No. I guess it means we're gonna be... Oh! How would I know? The worst thing I think I did today... my biggest regret... I ate popcorn before recording. I think I may have talked about this before, but the most annoying thing about it is, holy crap, is the fact that the kernels like break off. Oh my god, they like break off and then they get stuck everywhere. So like I'll be, this thing's just hitting me with everything. So I'll be talking and then suddenly a kernel will just fly into my teeth, in the way of my teeth, and I'll be like, oh, oh, oh. So if you hear a little cracking in the mic, it might be just me snipping down some kernels. Or the, whatever the, oh, this is on your stand. Ferrothorn's scary, man. It's so bulky, but it, like, it's not because I have fire type. How many energy roots you got left? 200. Okay. See, now we're in the, I think we're in the realm now of fully evolved Pokemon. Oh, please, we're eating this. Come on, man. We eat it. That literally brought us down to what we had before we healed. So not bad. Leafeon. Do I trust Malware against it? Yes. Let's do it, Malware. The boy. Let's signal beam right now. We're eating this. Look at this. Yummy. I would love having tri-attack, though, because adaptability will make it super strong. Give me a new move, because I only have one. Yeah, I'll take that. Having another special attack. Why is Porygon Zed have, like, the... I mean, sure, I'll get rid of Swagger. I think, yeah. We got 2 discharge mons now. And Vibe is leveling up. Talonflame. A Brave Bird can hurt. And the reason I'm saying that is because of the fact that I have, after level 40, high power moves and smart trainers on. So, we'll see how this goes. That'll hurt too. But no smart IVs, because that would make this crazy. I don't know if I'd be able to beat the game. This at least gives me a challenge, and I feel like I will be able to beat the game, or at least I have a chance at doing it. If I'm talking really loud, I apologize. I have my headphones on, and I can't hear myself properly, so everything's kind of muffled. I would like a grass type. I bet you I have a grass type in my PC, I just don't know it. So far, this hasn't been crazy hard. Okay, you better land this. Because you've been doing well. Every time we click jump kick, you've landed. Let's go. Right now, Lopunny is being the best it can very much be. And she is taking care of, taking out lives, basically. Oh, yo. Stay in. Land it. Let's go. It's a dead Mariana. And that's the match. So sad thing is, you can get mega forms. Yes! In the wild, but Earthquake is base 100. And I'd rather have Earthquake over Earth Power, to be honest. I would love to catch a wild Mega Evolution. Like, that'd be down. I'd be down.
Oh my god, this reminds me of the battle we had back on Route 103. We were able to become strong because you battled me back then, right, Krygo? What would you think if I said something like that? Oh my god, it's so cool. I'm actually thinking that it's about time I went back to the little route, though. I've caught a lot of Pokemon, and my Pokedex is, like, really complete, so I think I should go show it to my dad. Huh? Did something just sparkle in your bag? Oh my god, that light from that meteorite. Oh my god, no, nothing. I'll just forget about it. Oh my god, dude.
Oh my god, I keep losing this voice.
Oh my god, I'm probably just imagining things. Krygo, where are you going to do? You collect the gym badges and head to the Pokemon League Challenge? Like, it's not like it's been, what, 21? This is the 21st episode? I should know what you're doing by now. Oh my god, that's so typical of you. While you're collecting your badges, I guess I'll go and complete my Pokedex. I guess I'll be off then.
It feels like May is doing, you know the thing when you go to, like, math class, and you're with your friend, and you're like, oh, I'm really tired, so I'm not gonna, or I'm gonna play on my phone in class, and your friend's like, okay, I'll take notes, and you're like, okay, I'll copy off you after class. And then, so this is just the same thing, like, I'm gonna go do badges, and the important things. Actually, let's check my PC. I haven't looked at my PC in a while. What? I bet you I've looked in it last episode, I just can't remember. Do I have a grass type in here? I literally haven't caught a single grass type this entire last play. Except for the Fungus at the very beginning. You had an item, right? Yeah. And then I have a Fungus back here. There we go. Well, we're gonna go buy Pokeballs and then head to get a few encounters. Is it? Oh, I can do the lottery as well. Are you the lottery lady? There it is. Yes, I'll try it. 16511. You know what? I'm gonna leave. I don't care. Let's see what they got. Sell some Ultra Ball, buy some Ultra Balls, we'll buy. Let's buy 16. 16. There. Boom. I don't think there's anything for me to. I can sell things to you, right? I got 2 nuggets for you. What else do I got? Just sell. Do you want the red orb? Pokeballs, hearts, yeah, that's it. I have all these. How much is he busy? 500. That thing's worth a lot more than that. I'm gonna save the vitamins just in case, like, for other things. Is the TM room floor? No, TM floor is next floor. Yeah. I think you just sell normal TMs. Fireblast Thunder. So it's Thunder, Fireblast stuff. I don't think there's anything I actually want to use there. It's normal. I can't randomize TMs in this game. I don't know why. I've clicked everything. I've played with the files. Like, I don't know, man. Having trouble with that, but it's whatever. Oh, it's, okay, you know what's weird? In the store, or in buildings, you snap to a grid, but outside you can, like, do circles and stuff. Funky. Do I have a surf on? I do. Let's get a new encounter for Lily Cove City. Well, isn't she like saying she trains the Wilmer? I'm not picking that up because I've made a promise never to use the dex now. No, I'm only part of the water. Who are you? I'm training, get lost. Okay, first encounter is gonna be a Raichu. I'll take it. Still gonna be a moment kill. I hope. It is a Porygon Zed, so I'm not sure. But I don't think it should, right? Oh, yeah, it kills. Maybe I should be a little bit smarter about how I use my Pokemon when I'm catching. Anyways, we're gonna head back to... Oh wait, there was Swampert out here! That was Swampert's cry! I have Swampertite! Damn. I mean, that being said, I already have a Mega on my team, but like, who cares? Okay, now we have to go back to dodging trainers. Well, first I'm gonna actually go and spray a repel. Already battled you. The hell was that cry? I'm not sure what that was. I'm hoping we can get something decent in Mount Pyre. Oh my god. What the hell? Damn it, I thought I snuck by him. So your base trainer wall. Oh, okay, I thought that was Heatran. I was like, no, no, no. You know what I mean? I mean, my best answer for Eatmore is my highest level Pokemon. Well, who cares? I want to try to keep the team as evenly leveled as possible. I thought that... Is that Inferno? Oh my god. That's a 50% accuracy move. Why are you landing it? I was playing my son... My personal son randomized file. Just for fun. And I battled one of the trainers and she had a Torkoal in the Elite Four. And I was like, okay, this is fine, I'll just beat it. And the thing had Inferno, and I kid you not, it landed Inferno 3 times in a row. And if I remember correctly, Inferno has a 50% accuracy. I double checked it. Isn't it like boost grass type moves? Yeah. So I was like, can you stop? Because Inferno does a lot of damage, as well as having the chance to burn. Thank you. There's Keldeo over here. I'm still sad. Do you give me something? Volbeat. No, no, no. We're not using a Volbeat. This is like Route 122. That's a new encounter. There's Weezing out here, I think that is. I kind of am really tempted to get that, but I don't... I know people have done it where you get one per badge, so like, after the first gym you have one, and then after the second gym you get another one, but you have to use them between the badges. But I don't want to, I'd rather be surprised with what I get, and if it is something that's on the thing, that's a Weezing. I'll take that. We are going to click and throw ourselves. I think Nest Balls are still strong up to level 30. Don't correct me if I'm wrong, but I I think so. Nope, I was wrong. I'm gonna name this thing. I don't know how to name it. First, we actually gotta catch it. Oh, I got a great name for it. Never mind. Okay, I have to weaken it first, I guess. Weezing has good special defense, if I remember correctly. How about a signal beam? Because I'm just too lazy to switch Pokemon. Oh, he's fine. And now we're going to Ultra Ball it. One, two, three. Let's go. Level 41, Malware. Let's go, my dude. You're catching up. Weezing's dad has been added. Are you in this region? Yes, you are. Damn. We're gonna name you Wimis. I don't know why. Is it W-H-M-I-S? I don't remember. Is it Wimis? Yeah, it's W-H-M-I-S. Or is it Wimis? Like, Wimis. No, it was W-H-M-I-S. You know, I'm gonna use my mouse, because I mean my stylus. The touchscreen, because Wimis is... because school's starting, and my friends are going into doing all their fun sciences, so my friend was just talking to me about doing a test on the Wimis symbols. So for some reason that name kind of came to mind. Is there a different encounter table over here? No, there's not. This is the other side, right? Okay, I'm curious, what is that? Is that a Basculin? What is that? It sounds like a small Pokemon though. Oh, it's Blitzel! That's like way off, my guess. You're level 34. Oh, it's because it's a Dex Snap encounter. I just have to get a drink of water. I'm curious, what's on the other side of this? I got an encounter here, right? 123. I don't remember, and I don't want to, like, assume I haven't. So I'm gonna assume that I haven't, sorry. And that's okay. No, we're just going across to get another encounter in Mount Pyre, which is a graveyard. There's Haunter in here. They did a great job revamping the music for this game. Because it's the same music as they had in Ruby Sapphire, but they just fixed it. Made it better. They fixed it up. Yeah, Jessica. Quidditch is one of those Pokemon that's really annoying because it's got so many resistances that it's just like... Oh, wow. That's an energy ball and a half, man. Ready? Jump kick. Goodbye. And it's also really bulky, apparently. That's a crit! Okay, how about you calm down and don't do that again? Because... yeah. I need to switch, because this thing is going to keep clicking that, and it'll... just hurt more and more, because it's reducing my special defense. I didn't know Energy Ball did that. Wait, the lights are the eyes. That makes sense. Look at this, we're eating it. Take a Lava Plume. It should be neutral, so it should do a chunk of damage, if not kill. Oh, it knows Brine, too. That's fair. One more. I'm pretty sure we were faster anyways, but thank you, Quick Claw. That was useful. Okay, guys, I have a question for you. I was talking about popcorn earlier in the episode. So, what is your favorite snack? Your chill snack? Like, something you're watching a movie or a TV show at home. and you know, you need to, you gotta eat something when you're watching a movie, right? You can't say, oh no, I eat, like, I don't eat anything, because that's a Diggersby, if I remember cry correctly. But so you gotta choose something. So what is your favorite, like, movie snack? Obviously movie snacks like popcorn. But like, I don't know. Oh, it's an Ursa Ring. I will actually gladly use an Ursa Ring. You should live a signal beam. Right? That was a crit. Slash does a lot of damage. Oh, that was a crit as well. We're just trading crits today. That's how we're feeling. Play nice. Okay, Ursa Ring. I kind of want to do the really cheesy name, but it's a female. Never mind. What's the name of Yogi Bear's girlfriend? If you can call her that. Okay. Funny story. So I used to go to a camp as a kid. And we used to sing a song about them. Sorry guys, my audio may have just cut. So we used to sing a song in camp. And basically, it was about them. We'd sing about Yogi, his entire Jellystone and all that, so it's like, I'm trying to remember. Oh, we're gonna go up again. Oh, Cindy! I'm gonna name you Cindy. Cindy Bear. This boy is. I love Yogi Bear. I love Ursa Ring's design. Your name is Cindy. Can I name you Cindy Bear? I totally can. Your name is Cindy Bear. I am so sorry. Editing this is gonna be a. Suck. Gonna suck. So I'm trying to think of how I'm gonna sync this up later on. I'll have to remember when it happened and just hope and pray I can cut it in time. If this is out of sync now, I apologize. But I hit a cable that turned off my mic for a millisecond there. And so there's not a lot I could do about that. Hopefully it's fine. I didn't notice it, but then a thing popped up on my screen and I was like, wait! I gotta figure out the setup properly. Yeah, start. I can never see Carbon Kitchen Stonehenge. I should use Meteor Match, it's quite effective. It's fine, it's dead anyways. I'm actually gonna wrap it up here, guys. Hold on. Since this battle is over. In the next episode, we're gonna go upstairs, deal with Team Magma, because this episode I gotta wrap it up. Just because of the fact I also got some stuff to do. School starts in 2 days for me! If you live in Canada, or actually when this goes up tomorrow, if you live in Canada, good luck with school, guys. It's gonna be fun. Have a fun time, whatever grade you're in. It's gonna be awesome. I gotta go get some shopping done. Back to school shopping. And as always, you guys, I'll see you in the next video. See you then, guys.